a society where youths are not involved in the decision making. I will show you the society that has failed. 30% of membership in support group are youths. And support group is a very important organ as long as any political party is concerned. Is here. Because what we are discussing here, he is taking it straight to Sei Tinubu. And Sei Tinubu will take it straight to the president. Your input will be heard by the president. Yeah. To interact. We are here to discuss. We are here. They are here to listen to our challenges and our inputs.
To come and find out after 1 year in office. Support groups, because you are the stakeholders. Without you, we will not be in federal today. Am I lying?
Yes.
So we want to find out all these government initiatives. Are you people tapping into it?
No.
We want to find out what are the challenges you are facing.
Thank you.
We want you to know that the president loves you. The president wants to work with you. The president wants to keep what you pay. Make sure that we are, Baba is the president today, right? So wherever is coming, they should first offer you before taking it out to any obedient, to any other party. Me, I'm a party man, you. I'm a party man. I don't want anyone in Nigeria, I want Nigeria policies.
I'm glad this meeting has taken place. It's quite timely because a lot of the youth, most of the stakeholders of the party, have been discouraged and agitating for a reaction from above. So it shows that the president, his son, I mean, the entire Renewco team is pro the people. It's pro the people, and it's soothing to know that back there, over there, they know that the renewed hope has not really, really, really touched the people down here. The hope has not really been renewed. And they've come with a word of hope and encouragement. And I know that we have confidence that from now henceforth there will be a change. We are glad that this has taken place. The hope of the people has truly, truly been renewed today.
It is a way, my way, of accommodating support groups. We are numerous. So if you want 10,000 people made up of support groups by tomorrow, 2 p.m., shall we? So that support groups, the importance of support groups cannot be overemphasized. We are extremely sophisticated that we should not be joking with. Because of one or two corrections, they will underestimate or underrate the governor of Cross River State. Enough! The governor is the leader of everything in Cross River State and the dance outside. So that even if it is being that is coming from federal government of Nigeria, should pass through the governor that is the most accessible governor in Nigeria. Then let me also say this. I was embarrassed. We know ourselves in Cross River State that some names are mentioned, some names that have benefited from federal appointments, those names have never come in APC Cross River State. But they will come get appointment in Abuja. Enough is enough.
Kaka, we are here to engage with our support groups in Cross River State, and alhamdulillah, from the turnout, the engagement, we find out what most of our people need. And basically politics or governance is all about engagement. So these are stakeholders that made sure President Tinubu was elected. So it's only right that after a year in office, you need to come and sit with them to find out if their expectations have been met. Back by the God of God with the record to also see what we can do with that. It's encouraging because people are poor that they have. Some people are angry, some people are misinformed, but at the end of the day, what matters is what the take home is, and everybody has agreed that the government is doing a lot, but we need to do more in communicating this information, and then a whole lot that when the report is out, people will see.
Town hall meeting to engage support groups, especially the youth, so as to push a way forward for the youth and by extension the support groups of APC who worked assiduously very hard to ensure that our president emerged as elected president in 2023. And it is also a way of introducing a reward system for support groups who contribute so much during campaigns and elections. And the participants were so joyous and in high spirit, appealing to the president to do more. And most importantly, we have agreed here today that it is unacceptable for any person or group of persons to go to Abuja to undermine the prowess and the powers of the governor of Cross River State, who happens to be the leader of South-South APC. And like in Cross River State, some persons will go lobby for positions. So we want the president to allow the governor to coordinate federal appointments that comes to Cross River State, because he knows those who worked so hard during the campaign and the election.
Meeting we just finished is a stakeholders meeting, especially for youth groups. This meeting looked at, evaluated the impact of the government, especially the federal government, on the youths and what the government has done so far. The forum discussed about how youths can be impacted upon, youths can be empowered, youths can be employed, youths can benefit from appointments. And then the forum also gave a vote of confidence on the governor of Cross River State, Senator Prince Basio II, for his performance so far. And then the forum also have agreed, has told the federal government that the Calabar port should be dredged. And the forum also has said that the appointments at the federal level, especially the cabinet appointment, the ministerial appointment, Cross River State had two positions, and the forum has appealed to the presidency that those two ministerial positions should be retained in Cross River State. Also, the forum has opened up avenues that the presidency, the Renewed Hope agenda, has for the youth, especially in empowerment and entrepreneurship. And so the youths are ready to benefit the Cross River youths.
Youth interface today was so wonderful in the renewable engagement. It shows how the youth have a synergy within themselves, propelled by the son of the president, Mr. Shehu Tinubu, who has been doing well to bring the youth closer to governance. And we appreciate him today for this meeting. We thank him for his engagement so far across the speech of the Federation. He has been doing a wonderful job even during our campaign. He has been engaging youth and getting them involved. And today's program create a room like a round table discussion where youths have an avenue to express their mind and come up with ideas on the way forward. And talking about the representative of Shehu Tinubu, he spoke very well and assured the youth that he's going to make a way for the president to get this information directly via Shehu Tinubu.
This Renewed Hope Youth engagement with support groups, ably organized by the son of our principal, Mr. Shehu Tinubu. The essence of this program is to go around the entire state and feel the pulses of all the youths and support groups in this country. You know, he has realized that over time, the things for the youths and support groups had already remained in Abuja. So he took it upon himself and his team to go around the country, moving from one state to the other, to get the opinions of different support groups and youth groups. And by God's special grace, a lot of people have spoken. They have talked about how support groups have been sidelined, you know, after election, because we put in our resources. The youths the support groups, we put in our resources, we put in our time, we supported the party with our might, and by God's grace, the party emerged victorious. So, what this team has done is a good thing, because they have taken, we have spoken our mind, and our opinion, our input, our questions will be taken to Abuja for the president to launch into action right away, because very soon we are getting to 2027, we will be needed again.